بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم أتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا وقال تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين صدق الله العظيم. Listen, dear brothers, right now we are experiencing the most special days in the Islamic calendar. The first 10 days of Zulhijjah, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the special ummah of the special Nabi, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Allah hasn't given any ummah before this. The most special Nabi of Allah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, the most beloved, the best of ummahs, khayr, kuntum khayra ummah, you are the best of ummahs, Allah has chosen us. Allah has given us the perfect deen. Today we are sitting in the house of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, the 9th of Zulhijjah, 1443. The day of Jumu'ah, corresponding to the same that happened in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final hajj, hajjatul wada', the farewell hajj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for whom Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made this entire earth, the ummah, the jinnat, to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, wahi had come down in the 9th year of nubuwat, 9th year of hijrah, in Madinatul Munawwara. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. Fardiyat of hajj. The Nabi of Allah, the 9th year of hijrah, now hajj is fard upon you and the ummat. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ. With the pleasure of Allah, Allah has made the hajj of his bayt, of the baytullah, farz upon you. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned to sahaba ikram also, the furida alaykum wal hajj. The hajj has become farz upon you, fahujju, make hajj. 9th year of the hijrah, hajj became farz. Amul wufud, it was called the year of the wufud and those jamaats and people that should come to Madinatul Munawwara. There were plenty of them that were coming during that year of wufud. The different groups of people were coming to accept Islam. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, this was an amr muhim, very important matter to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. That now people are coming towards Islam, educate them. That year was full of jamaats upon jamaats were coming to Madinatul Munawwara. Hajj became fard. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, they after made i'lan, an announcement, after this year, no mushrik will make hajj or baytullah. The 9th year of Nubuwat, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam appointed Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Bakr, take the Muslims for hajj. To fulfill the fardiyat, the obligation. That year Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu took the people for hajj. The following year, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam made i'lan. And announced in the 10th year of Nubuwat, 10th year of Hijrah, not Nubuwat, of Hijrah, after Hijrah, the 10th year, that this year I will make Hajj. And Sahaba Ikram rallied around Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam from all over the Muslim world. This is the first Hajj after Nubuwat and possibly the last Hajj also. An entire Jamaat of Sahaba radiallahu anhu moved to Makkatul Mukarrama. Reach Makkatul Mukarramah the 4th of Zulhijjah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam making Qiran Hajj. On the 8th, went to Mina. Read Salah in Abtah in Makkatul Mukarramah on the 8th morning. Proceeds to Mina thereafter. Sunnat, 5 Salah in Mina. Zuhar, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, Fajr. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam performed Salah in Mina. Sahaba ikram around him. Then he told them, turn towards them, wait a while. And he recites Takbir-e-Tashriq, the 9th of Zulhijjah, which is tomorrow morning at Fajr. Takbir-e-Tashriq began, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallahu, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Just after sunrise, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, out to Arafat. As this morning, today also, the hadith have gone to Arafat. Before coming to Arafat, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, Sahaba ikram, put up a tent for me in Namira, near Arafat. Where we have Masjidun Namira, the masjid in Arafat. Put up a tent for me there, made of the cloth and the hair of an animal. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam proceeds. And during the days of Jahiliyyah, the Quraysh would not go to Arafah for Hajj. They would stop at Muzdalifah. Out of pride and their arrogance, we are not like others. They can go to Arafah, we'll stay in Muzdalifah. So Sahaba Ikram were waiting in anticipation. Nabi of Allah, will he stop at Muzdalifah? Will he move on? New ahkam, new sharia. Something you'll never see again. The group of Sahaba radiallahu anhum. How many years of Qurbani in Makkatul Mukarrama? Now finally we are making Hajj with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they proceed past Muzdalifah, they come into Arafah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam sits camp. Just after Zawal, Zuhur time sets in. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam gets onto his qaswa, his camel, she camel. And he goes into the plains, into the place of Arafah. Get the Sahaba ikram around him. Rabi'a bin Umayyah radiallahu ta'ala anha is appointed. His father was murdered, was killed in the battle of Badr, fighting against the Muslims. Now he was appointed. You will now repeat the words of the khutbah of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, so all may hear it. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam began the khutbah, that listen, O my Sahaba. It is possible that you will not see me after this year. This is the last Hajj of my life. You will not meet again. Remember, your honor, your blood, your wealth is honored, sanctified in the court of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. كَيُومِكُمْ هَذَا As this day, the 9th of Zulhijjah. وَشَارِ هَذَا And this month of Zulhijjah. And the city of Makkatul Mukarram, a sanctified place. You will not meet again. Listen to my words. That today I make all your lives honorable, sanctified. You should not hurt another Muslim brother. You should keep the honor of a Muslim brother. This was the value of a Muslim in the eyes of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A true Muslim, man salim al muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadi. A Muslim is that person from whose hands other Muslims are safe, from his tongue, from his hands. This is the meaning of Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. That when you say to a Muslim, Salam, you are safe from me, physically, emotionally. When it comes to your material belongings also. But this was given in the last khutbahs of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The honor of a Muslim. Don't cheat him. Don't backbite him. Don't hurt his feelings. An entire life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was only this. Allegations, slander, persecution. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ Allah revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Nabi of Allah, we made insan to live in chaos, in difficulty, in mushkilat, in shada'id. That by default life is difficult. From the time he got nubuwat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until his mubarak eyes closed, there was no rest for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is how the life of insan will be. If anything you enjoy, make the shukr of Allah. This is against the norm. The norm is kabad, difficulty, chaos. Every Nabi of Allah's life was difficult. Today, unfortunately, because of the secular education and environment we have around us, they might not tell us openly, but we grew up with this concept, a certain dream. I gotta have a nice house and a nice car and a beautiful wife and children that are settled, secured financially. Nothing wrong with it. But this is not the goal. The goal is the pleasure of Allah. That Allah must become happy with me in every condition. But this dream that we have been indoctrinated with, that this is life, sacrifice everything. As one professional says, he says, Mufti Saab, the time has come now where the career of the young man and to make it in life has become his God. Has become his religion. He's prepared to sacrifice everything for it. Whether he be his young wife also, he has a contract foreign, I have to go. Whether his beloved mother also, he's prepared to sacrifice the comfort of his home. Prepared to sacrifice the command of Allah also, the creator, the one that gave him everything. Insan is made to live in difficulty. From the time his mother conceived, till the time she gave birth, was only difficulty for her. Bringing him into this world was difficult. To suckle him was difficult. To wean him off was difficult. Then his The appearance of his teeth also was difficult for him. Then him walking, falling, crawling. Allah says, your entire life will be difficult. Understand this. If you want ease, Allah has kept it in salah. Allah has kept it in his remembrance. Allah has kept it in Quran tilawat. As one poet says, that you are looking at haram. You're looking at ghayr mahram women. You see, you're looking for the pleasure of Jannat in Jahannam. You will not get the pleasure of Jannat in haram. Allah has kept it in his obedience. Jannat in life is kept in the obedience of Allah. The storms will be raging around us. The storms will be raging around us, but a person's heart is connected to Allah, he will enjoy the storm because the storm is taking me higher to my Allah. The waves are pushing me higher to my Allah. And his entire ocean is enjoying himself in the muhabbat of Allah. The tears are flowing and he's saying to Allah, ya Allah, I'm not looking for the ocean. I'm not looking for the shore. I'm not looking for the shore. As long as his halat and condition bring me closer to you, like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Allah, this is my success. Not breaking the command of Allah and looking for sweetness of dunya. The honor of a Muslim, his wealth, his honor, his life is honorable in the court of Allah. The same khutbah Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, that being the 9th of Zul Hijjah, remember that from today I have cancelled all usury transactions. All riba is cancelled. There will be no more riba now. No more interest. That was cancelled on the 9th of Zul Hijjah in Arafah. Wasiyat was given. Oh my ummah, be careful. Don't get involved with interest-based transactions. The last wasiyat of the life of Rasulullah, which is most important. Look into our lives, my dear brothers. Where and where we are burning our fingers. Different transactions, interest, somebody investing with me. But there's no agreement. I will pay you so much a month. There's no percentage, is a figure. We know that becomes haram. It has to be a percentage. How the person invested with me, when it comes to the insurances and the different aids, medical aids, etc. As ulama ikram. And how often we hear, my dear brothers, that my credit card is maxed. I'm paying interest every month. Living and paying on the credit card upon the credit card. We're on this day, on the blessed occasion of Hajjatul Wada', the 9th Dhul Hijjah, in the plains of Arafat, the message was given that all interest transactions are now cancelled. No more interest of the ummah to lend on interest, to pay the interest, to take the interest, to get involved in bribery, to secure contracts. Oh my ummah, Allah has made rosy easy. Perform your salah. Perform your salah. It is impossible, my dear brothers, impossible that a person is fulfilling the command of Allah in the masjid, standing before the creator, the nourisher, provider, sustainer, the one that engineered our brains, the one that did the wiring, the one that did our inner plumbing, so to say, and everything we have. And I'm standing before Allah and saying, Allahu Akbar, Allah is giving me full attention. Complete attention from Allah. But my heart is inattentive. The Creator is giving me to stand before the King. And He's calling you to give you, not to take from you. Ulama said it is impossible that you stand before Allah in obedience in salah and Allah will destroy your dunya. Is impossible. Impossible. It might look destruction outwardly. The eyes is deceiving. So this was the day, my dear brothers, where Nabi Ali said, abolish all intense transactions. Get it out of our lives. We can see the nuhusa, the evil effect on it. Whether it comes to my children eating it, living on overdraft, or whatever it may be, whichever way it may be, the du'as I am making, but not getting accepted. Something I would see into my accounts, 1 cent of riba, 1 cent of interest, I had to pay an account late, or the credit card as I mentioned, we are paying it. That was equally haram than taking it. On this day, Nabi Ali Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam made the wasiyat. That don't take the property of your Muslim brother without his pleasure. Don't take the property and mal of a Muslim brother without his consent. Don't force it out of him. Be a pillar for him. Support him. He's going down. Don't think to yourself, he's going down. He's got a property. So he's got a price on it. I know he's going down. Just offer him the cash and bring him down more. Go and help the brother. You're taking it from him without the happiness of his heart. There's no barakat in it. Somebody will suffer the consequences of that transaction. When I help the brother, I heard you going down. What can we do for you? What can we do for you? And for myself, if I'm helping someone else, ulama say, remember, if you are helping someone else in reality, Allah put his rozi, his sustenance, that person's in your pocket. Allah Ta'ala put his food on your dasturkhan. It wasn't yours, it was for him. Allah sent it for him via you. So his wealth also is sanctified, has hurmat behind it, is honorable in the court of Allah. Don't take it. Help the Muslim brother, build an ummat. On this day, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam also mentioned, take care of your wives. You make the tarbiyat, bring them onto deen. Don't beat them up emotionally. Secure them also. How we speak to them, how we address them. Yes, they have the shortcomings, but that too, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them like that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what akhlaq wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azeem. O Nabi of Allah, the franchise of good akhlaq belongs to you. We've given it to you. Anyone wants to learn about good character has to come back to you. But then too, he will say to Aisha radiallahu anha, Aisha, I know when you are upset with me, I know when you are happy with me. O Nabi of Allah, how do you know? When you say, Bi Rabbi Ibrahim, I know that now you are upset with me, you take a qasam in the name of my grandfather Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And when you please with me, you say, Bi Rabbi Muhammad, qasam in the name of the Rabb of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. The question, my dear brothers, what's the reason to get upset with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam? What akhlaq, what character, the perfect human being. But Allah has made them that way. They will get upset, the emotional beings. And we don't allow them to vent it. We don't take care of the feelings or the emotions. Azwaj mutahharat, they had also the ups and downs. The mothers of the ummah. Who can be a better husband than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? But how you accommodate with a smile. During Hajj also, in Arafat, he had all the wives around him. And he gave all his nasihat. Approximately 80 days left for the demise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then wahi comes down. The narrator says, Nabi alayhi salatu gave the khutbah. Then Adhan called Bilal, Bilal called out the Azan. Azan was given. 9 Zulhijjah, place Arafah, day of Arafah. Call out the Azan. This is a special day. This is a special day where we have received this entire procession of Hajj, Qurbani, Tawaf, Safa, Marwa. Don't forget your grandfather Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. The Qurbani he gave. My life came out in Qurbani. Allah commanded me. Thumma awhina ilayka nittabi'. O Nabi of Allah, you follow millata Ibrahim hanifa. The religion, the way of life of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, hanifa, cut yourself off completely everything besides Allah. Al-I'arad anil-adyan al-batila. They turn away from all different types of religions and ways of life. It's only one way. Not the Abrahamic accord, what they're talking about today. Everything is mixed up. That was Hanifa. Cut off from every type of creed, religion. This Hanifa comes in Quran over and over again. Ibrahim Hanifa, Hanifa, Hanifa. They're cutting himself off from everything besides Allah and the religion and the way of life of Islam. That entire family of three, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, and Hajar radiallahu ta'ala anha, the Qurbani, they made Allah loved it so much. As we heard many times on this member also. That on that day of Qurbani which is coming ahead, the Qurbani given by all Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam till we got the Hajj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Where that little baby was left behind with the mother. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam leaving. 1 year later he returns. In that period of time, Hajar radiallahu ta'ala anha, the second day as she was left alone in that valley, no vegetation, no food, no water. And the hot sun of Makkah al-Mukarramah, beating down on the sand. The sand is hot, where do I place the baby? Where do I place this baby? There's no cot, there's no pram, there's no facilities, nothing whatsoever. We can imagine the hands of the mother, how it must have been become heavy, burden to carry this child. Food coming to an end. 2 days, 3 days. Mufassirin say, out of desperation, out of desperation. Ya Allah, where do I put this child down? I'm tired also. My chest has become empty to feed this child. The food is finished, the water is finished. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, over 80 years old, he's gone back to Palestine. The foundation was being laid for this ummah to be sitting here today. Qurbani was given that time. This ummah had to come into existence. Deen came with Qurbani, with sacrifice. Deen would remain with sacrifice. Deen would spread with sacrifice. Not with luxuries, my dear brothers. We'll come with sacrifice. Deen will remain alive with our families with sacrifice. Out of desperation, nothing else to do, no way out, she leaves the baby on the hot sand. And this, the son of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, what do you say, royal blood. And she runs towards Mount Safa. She goes to Safa, and from there, from the hilltop, from the mountain top, she can see her little baby crying in anguish, pangs of hunger. Then she runs down from Safa. She comes into a plain, to the valley. When she comes down, that is where she begins to hasten, but she begins to run. Here ulama says she began to run because she could not see her baby anymore. So she went to Marwa. From there she could see the baby again, he's okay. Second time, a third time she ran. Allah, we can imagine Rabbul Alameen looking, look at my Hajar. This is all for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam's ummah to come into existence. The seventh time that she stopped was not because it was a command of Allah, because she was exhausted. How much more do I run now? Now she reaches Mount Marwa. She reaches the top, she looks into the distance, look at her baby. Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, and she finds something shining in the distance. She runs towards him. Before that she thinks, Ya Allah, if I have to die, better I die here, he dies there. I cannot see him dying in this condition. But she sees something coming out from the ground. She runs towards Ismail. And she sees the water gushing forth. And she says, Zam, 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 zam. Water, stop, stop. Well, the world has become flooded with zam, zam. The source of zam, zam, jannat. Allah gave it to us in this world. More than 4,000 years, more or less approximately, the water is still flowing. What Qurbani given? 1 year later, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam comes to visit her on his camel. And she gets up to greet him. He says, no mulaqat. The only permission for ziyarat and visiting, that's all. Hands the baby over to him. He holds the child to his bosom, kisses the child Ismail, hands it back to her. Assalamu alaikum. Qurbani upon Qurbani. وَإِذِ ابْتَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ. Allah says, remember the time when we tested Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam with every type of test. فَأَتَمَّهُنْ. He passed with flying colors. He became the friend of Allah, Jalla Jalalu. Now Mufassirin say about 10, 12 years later, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is given permission, now over 90 years old. His son, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعْهُ السَّعْيَ, which is the age where he can run around, he can play, he can work with his father, run with his father. Mufassirin say some 7 years old, some say 10 years old, some say 13 years old, between 10 and 13. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam comes. Before he comes to Makkatul Mukarramah, he sees the dream and slaughtering my son. The first night was the 8th of Zulhijjah. He wakes up in the morning, Rawa Ibrahim, he begins to ponder, tafakkara. That this dream I saw, was it from Allah or Shaitan? The whole of 8th Zulhijjah yesterday, for the people of the Hajjis, was 8th yesterday. Today is our 8th. The entire day he spent in thinking, what do I do about this dream? The dreams of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam are wahi, revelation from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. On the 9th Zulhijjah night, he goes to bed. He sees a dream again, slaughtering his son. Wakes up in the morning, Arafa Ibrahim wa anna hadhi ru'ya min Allah. Arafa, Ibrahim realized that this dream is from Allah. That day became Yomu Arafa, the day of recognizing, understanding, knowing that now this dream is from Allah, is a command of Allah. He goes back to bed that night, he sees a dream once again. Wakes up in the morning, he comes to Ibrahim, Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, after 12, 13 years, takes the hand of his son, let's go towards Mina. Doesn't know what's happening. That day is called Yomun Nahr, the day of slaughter. Father and son walking towards Mina. Then he says to his son, Inni ara fil manam, anni adba'uka, oh my son, I've seen in a dream that I'm slaughtering you. فانظر, think a little bit before you speak. ماذا ترى? What is your eye? What is your suggestion? What do you think about it? It was a test from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. The young boy, what answer will he give? Your ulama explain the reply he gave. ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. Oh my beloved father, without hesitation, there's no word, no fear. That soon, just now, carry out the command of Allah. افعل ما تؤمر. Carry out the command of Allah. You will find me among those that are patient. The question ulama ask, what inspired this young boy of 12, 13 to give such a mature answer? Quran, Allah recorded the Quran Sharif. What is the blood? Was it the blood of his father, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam? Was it the tarbiyat of his mother, Hajar radiallahu ta'ala anha? He said both. Father was fulfilling the purpose of his life, striving in the path of Allah. And the mother, making sabr at home. The jihad of the women of the time is to stay within their homes. That is the jihad, Hadith Sharif says. Women to stay within their homes is jihad for them. Them staying at home is equal to the reward of a mujahid giving his life in the path of Allah. You see, this was the tarbiyat of the Muslim mother who became the grandmother of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He gave the reply. And they say in Arabic, al-waladu sirrun li-abi, that the child is a secret to the father's heart. What the father has within his heart, what desires of deen he has within his heart, for Allah there's no boundaries. Allah sees the jazba and the dua of the father at night, when he's striving in the path of Allah, which masjid, which corner, giving 4 months in the path of Allah, somewhere in Pakistan, somewhere in India, somewhere in this locality, that locality, no facilities. He wakes up for tahajjud, he raises his hands, oh my Allah, my family, my children, my progeny, Allah, accept them, accept them, accept them. The dua that comes up from the heart. They say that child is a secret to the father's heart. What within the father's heart, you will see it in the child. And then to ulama say, father may be outwardly pious, dressed like a pious person, taqwa arch is here, or libasu taqwa arch is here. So dressed like the pious is something else, and taqwa piety is something else. Should not be that I dress like the pious, so I think I'm also pious. Piety is something else, something to achieve, something to work upon. He might look pious outwardly, but what's within the heart? I fear for my child's future, what will happen to her in case her husband has to pass away. So I have to get her educated. Oh my beloved father, if you pass today, pass away, what will happen to her? You worry about her husband passing away. If you pass away before she gets a degree, what will happen to her? Allah is there. Allah is there. Allah will always be there. Allah will not throw us away. Fulfill the command of Allah, He will not throw us away. So the Qurbani was given. Then we got Qurbani. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam takes his son, dagger in his hand, knife in his hand, sharpened to cut. We know the whole incident, my dear brothers. The knife did not cut. Allah Ta'ala sent the ram down, we got Qurbani. If that was not the mansha of Allah, the will of Allah, and Allah knows best, we would have waited now for 13 years of my son to get to that age, sharpened my knife for 13 years. If Allah had accepted the Qurbani as it was, the life of Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, that would have become the sunnat. But we know we wouldn't have been here also. But imagine now, I had to take now amongst my sons, take one slaughter him. Age 13, the way will there be happy birthday parties? And birthday parties, he's 13 years, he's reached the age, he'll be gone from this world. Where's the time to celebrate? The time to put our heads down before Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Qurbani was given. We got Qurbani. Allah loved her sa'i between Safa wal Marra. Hajar alayhi salatu wasalam running between Safa and Marra. Allah loved it so much, made it wajib upon the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. All those who came for Hajj had to do the same thing also. Run between Safa and Marwa. Bring Zamzam, the barakat of Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. Make Qurbani the barakat of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. One thing Allah Ta'ala gave us today, Qurbani. For us to understand that this deen came with Qurbani. When the call of Allah will come, and then when he built the Kaaba Sharif, now he is leaving. And the dua he made, dear Allah, I left him behind. When he left them, when he was a little boy, before the building of Kaaba, and he makes dua, Rabbana liyuqimu salah. Dear Allah, I left him behind for them to perform salah. Anbiya had this fikr, that my children will perform salah. Their success Today we find the masjid for Jumu'ah Salah is to capacity, my dear brothers. When you come to Asr of today, to the Maghrib of tonight, where the Ummah is going to? It's a cry. We've tried everything to get our country in order, to get our roads in order, our supplies in order, and all our departments in order in our country, whether it be the load shedding, the water shedding, we've tried everything. But things are getting worse. There's only one solution, is Allah. Jalla Jalalu. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tomorrow the 9th of Zulhijjah, my dear brothers, few amal to do. One is the fast on the 9th of Zulhijjah tomorrow. The reward for that, 2 years sins are forgiven. One day roza, the gunas and the sins of past year and present year all forgiven. The reward on that day equal to 10,000 days. 10,000 days Allah is giving reward. To understand this, the boss says, the owner says, the malik says, Allah is saying, give me one roza, I'm giving you 10,000. And here the boss says, give me just few minutes extra time, and I'll give you 10 years salary in advance. What will be the reply? Labbaik wa sa'adik. I'm ready. 10 minutes, 10 years salary advance, I'm ready for it. Allah is saying, give you 10,000 days advance already reward. For one day roza, the day of Arafah. And the best dhikr to make, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, that the best dua, the day of Arafah, and the best dhikr, and the best dua, the best dhikr, best wazifa, which I have recited in all Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam on the day of Arafah, 9th Zulhijjah, the fourth kalima. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير according to one narration to the Mizi Sharif Musnad Ahmad لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي يميت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. The reward of this, my dear brothers, you see, read this the entire day of the 9th Zulhijjah. The Rawi narrator says that was near Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam on his camel making dua on the day of Arafah, and every more than often now and then I heard him reciting this wazifa, La ilaha illallah. Here to conclude, ulama say, what's the reason behind this? Why this dua? In this dua, there's no asking of forgiveness, there's no asking of sustenance, there's no asking of jannat, to save oneself from fire of jahannam, for one, nothing. It's only the praise of Allah. Only the praise of Allah. Ulama explain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is akramul akrameen. The most kind of those that show kindness, the most generous. If you ask a generous person, a kind person for something, he might give you equal to what you ask or less. Very rarely he'll give you more. Here you're asking Allah. There you ask a generous person, he'll give you this. But if you praise the person, sing his praises, he'll give you more than you can expect also. The day of Arafah, they say, praise Allah, and in this is no asking of Allah. Allah will give you what you want and more than what you want also. Only praise Allah. Second reason, ulama say, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam knew how weak his ummah is. How much dua are you going to make? 50 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour? You're going to get tired, and you won't know what to ask, how to ask it. Read this wazifa, la ilaha illallah, fat kalima. Whatever you want to ask, whatever you asked, whatever you couldn't ask, Allah will give you more than all of that. Tomorrow we have the day of Arafah to keep fast. Then to read our fourth kalima. We can spend the day in the house of Allah and make amends to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Prepare for our Qurbani on the day of Qurbani also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the topic ability to understand, my dear brothers. Qurbani for deen, salah in our lives, our interest transactions to get our affairs right, very importantly. And when it comes to our families, take care of them, give them ta'aleem of deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to make amal.